What's up guys, and it's time to take a look at a phone that can almost be called as a flagship killer of 2020. I bring you the Oneplus 7 Pro. Oneplus, a company that started its journey by being the flagship killer, having the same specs as the higher priced Samsungs and LGs back in the days at a much cheaper price. Those were good times, but now things are changed. The new Oneplus 8 family is expensive than ever thanks to 5G and some other bells and whistles. They're still cheaper compared to the best of Samsung and Apple. Of course, that line is getting thinner and thinner every year, but if you compare the specs, Oneplus isn't cutting any corners short. They're competing with the best of the best in the market while at the same time giving you kind of a flagship killer. Yes, in the form of Oneplus 7 Pro. In comparison to the upcoming pricing of the Oneplus 8 and 8 Pro, this bad boy can be yours for even less than $400, which is absolutely crazy. If you go on eBay, there are a lot of deals currently going on. Which made me think, is this the best value champion in 2020? So I switched from my Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra, which was my main Android phone, to the Oneplus 7 Pro. So switching from the best of Samsung, which is the $1400 S20 Ultra, I gotta say, I really like the design of the Oneplus 7 Pro even more, because first of all, these cameras are just so clean looking, and with Galaxy S20 Ultra, we only get two colors. These are very basic colors. So going to the Oneplus 7 Pro, it was a breath of fresh air, seeing all these colors bouncing around. This is the blue color, which was my favorite from last year. And of course, this is a matte finish, which means goodbye fingerprints. Yes, this is always a clean looking boy, whereas on the Galaxy S20 Ultra or any glossy phone, you just have to deal with those fingerprints all the time. For me, I definitely prefer the matte finish, which is something that you don't see a lot on the smartphones right now, which makes this design one of my absolute favorite. Also, I will take a super fast optical fingerprint scanner over a 3D slower fingerprint scanner of the Galaxy S20 Ultra any day. Now, Oneplus 7 Pro is definitely one of the last good flagship phones to have a full screen uninterrupted experience. Oneplus is using a punch hole setup on the Oneplus 8 and 8 Pro, and a lot of people think that it's kind of a downgrade, but Oneplus definitely has some reasons for it. Obviously, you get IP68 rating, so it's more of a durability plus point there, but based on aesthetics and looks, this is definitely an absolute gorgeous display. And don't forget that Oneplus put a 90Hz refresh rate on this bad boy. It was a complete ahead of time move from Oneplus, especially in 2020, where you're gonna see so many phones with higher refresh rates. So this was an absolute must-have feature. And unlike Samsung, you actually get 90Hz refresh rate with full quad HD plus resolution. So if you wanna go all the way to the max, you can do that. Obviously it will hurt the battery, but yeah, it's nice to have this option. It's completely up to the user. Now the Galaxy S20 Ultra is definitely smoother, but the difference between the 120Hz and 90 is actually not that much. You really see that if you compare to a phone that has a 60Hz refresh rate. So 90Hz is definitely one of the sweet spots to get that good smooth experience, as well as having a better battery experience. Now performance wise, Oneplus devices are always one of the fastest phones on the market, and that is still going on with this phone. If you guys remember, I did a speed test with the Galaxy S20, and against the Exynos 990, the Snapdragon 855 did really well. It's still a really good chipset, which is why it's being used inside a $1400 Galaxy Z Flip. So Snapdragon 855 will take care of everything. You can play all your favorite games without any problem. It still is a full 60 FPS gaming experience on this phone. Now let's talk about the cameras. The main camera lens of the Oneplus 7 Pro is a 48 megapixel IMX 589 Sony sensor. That is actually the same sensor Oneplus is using on its Oneplus 8. So you're actually getting that same main camera awesomeness with this phone, unless you go with the Oneplus 8 Pro model, which is using a newer sensor. So compared to when this phone was first launched, the camera has improved a lot. You can take some stunning photos with good colors, nice vibrant pictures, good dynamic range. Oneplus really improved the camera with software update. They also added the ability to shoot night mode photos with ultra wide angle lens, and that actually does make a difference if you compare it to a phone like iPhone 11 Pro Max, which doesn't have the night mode. So in indoor situations, if you use the nightscape, the images will come out sharper. Also, now you can shoot 4K videos with ultra wide angle lens. It now has a 30 second long exposure mode, which is also called as tripod mode. So if you have the phone on tripod, you can do some good astrophotography. Now, one of the things that I still find amazing with the OnePlus 7 Pro is the ability to have full control in the camera setting thanks to the Pro mode. So in addition to the normal features like setting the aperture and ISO and white balance, you get the option to choose from JPEG and RAW, which is my favorite option because with RAW, you get a ton of detail, a uncompressed photo that you can work with later in Lightroom if you have experience with that. It definitely makes a difference and you can come up with some really, really good shots. Surprisingly, Samsung doesn't offer the RAW ability with its Pro mode, so something I really want them to add moving in the future. So for its current price, the camera is really, really good. Now, when we talk about the battery, I'm getting around 4 to 5 hours of screen on time on this phone, and that is slightly less compared to what I get on my Galaxy S20 Ultra, but not that noticeable. I mean, considering it's the last year phone, it's still doing pretty good. So all in all, I feel like the OnePlus 7 Pro is an absolute steal of a phone that you can get right now. While it doesn't have the 120Hz display or 5G or IP68 rating or even that ultra fast wireless charging that you're gonna see on the 8 Pro model, it is still an absolute good phone. If you don't care about those things and if you want to save some serious money, this is the smartphone that you should definitely consider. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Do you agree that OnePlus 7 Pro is an absolute best value for champ, best smartphone you can get right now? And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.